We all love to hear songs because of their lyrics, their tune, and the meaning that they convey. As said by Plato, music is a moral law. It gives soul to the universe, wings to the mind, flight to the imagination, gaiety to life, and charm to everything. But can you imagine music and songs to be a method of data transmission? Can you imagine music to be the only reliable form of passing on what has been learned? Because songs are primarily how the Vedic knowledge was passed on. The four Vedas are not books in the usual sense, but they comprise rather tonally accented verses and hypnotic, abstruse melodies whose proper realizations demand oral instead of visual transmission. The oral tradition of the Vedas or the Shruti consists of several pathas or recitations or ways of chanting the Vedic mantras. Vedic chantings use four tones, Udatta or the middle tone, Anudatta or the lower tone, Swarita or the higher tone, and the Dirgha Swarita, which is the high tone extended. These are usually marked with intuitive swara marks like an underline for a lower tone, a small vertical line above the letter for a higher tone, and two vertical lines for the Dirgha Swarita.
In the Vedic tradition, the students were taught to recite the mantras in a particular fashion. The various pathas or recitation styles are designed to allow the complete and perfect memorization of the text and its pronunciation, including the Vedic pitch accent. 11 such ways of reciting the Vedas were designed, namely the Samhita, Pada, Krama, Jata, Mala, Shikha, Rekha, Dvaja, Danda, Ratha, and Ghana, of which Ghana is usually considered the most difficult. The students were first taught to memorize the Vedas using simpler methods before teaching them the 8 complex recitation styles. These methods include continuous recitation, which is Samhita Patha, word by word recitation, which is Pada Patha, and Krama Patha, where the words are arranged in a pattern. The Samhita, Pada, and Krama Pathas can be described as the natural recitation styles or Prakriti Pathas. The remaining 8 modes of chanting are classified as complex recitation styles or Vikruti Pathas, as they involve reversing the word order. The backward chanting of words does not alter the meanings in the Vedic Sanskrit language.
Prodigious energy was expended by the ancient Indian culture in ensuring that these texts were transmitted from generation to generation with inordinate fidelity. Many forms of recitation or pathas were designed to aid accuracy in recitation and the transmission of the Vedas and other knowledge texts from one generation to the next. All hymns in each Veda were recited in a particular fashion. An example from Rigvedic Sandhya is Ishanavaryanam Shayantiksharshaninam. So all 1028 hymns with 10,600 verses of the Rigveda were preserved in this manner. Each text was recited in several ways to ensure that the different methods of recitation acted as a cross-check on the other. Samhita Patha is a continuous recitation of the Sanskrit words bound by the phonetic rules of euphonic combination. Pada Patha is a recitation marked by a conscious pause after every word and after any special grammatical codes embedded inside the text. This method suppresses euphonic combination and restores each word in its original intended form. Krama Patha is a step-by-step recitation where euphonically combined words are paired successively and sequentially and then recited. This method to verify the accuracy is credited to Vedic sages Gargya and Shakalya in the Hindu tradition and mentioned by the ancient Sanskrit grammarian Panini. The modified Krama Patha is the same step-by-step recitation as before, but without the euphonic combinations. This method to verify accuracy is credited to the Vedic sages Babhravya and Galava in the Hindu tradition, and it is also mentioned by the ancient Sanskrit grammarian Panini. Jata Patha, Dvaja Patha, and Ghana Patha are the methods of recitation of a text and its oral transmission that developed after the 5th century BCE that is after the start of Buddhism and Jainism. These methods use more complicated rules of combination and were less used. The insistence on preserving pronunciation and accent as accurately as possible is related to the belief that the potency of the mantras lie in their sound when pronounced. The shakhas thus have the purpose of preserving knowledge of uttering divine sound originally cognized by the rishis. The transmission of this knowledge was done by various shakhas of the Vedas. A shakha is a Hindu theological school that specializes in learning certain Vedic texts. Shaunaka's Charanavyuha lists 5 shakhas for the Rigveda: the Shakala, Bashkala, Ashvalayani, Shankhyayani, and Manduka, of which only the Shakala and Bashkala and very few of Ashvalayani are extant. The Yajurvedi shakhas are divided into Shukla and Krishna schools. The white recensions have separate Brahmanas, while the black ones have their much earlier Brahmanas interspersed between the mantras. Shukla Yajurveda has Madhyandina, Kanva, and Shatapatha Brahmana. Krishna Yajurveda has Taittiriya Samhita, Taittiriya Brahmana, Maitrayani Samhita, Charaka Katha Samhita, and Kapisthala Katha Samhita. The 2 Samved recensions that are extant today are the Jaiminiya and the Kauthuma. For the Atharva Veda, the 9 shakhas were as follows: Paipala, Danta, Pradanta, Stota, Auta, Brahmadayashada, Shaunaki, Vedadarsha, and Charanavidya. Out of these 9, the Shaunaki is the only shakha of the Atharva Veda for which both printed texts and an active oral tradition are still known to exist. Because this system of transmission was so intricate and compact, they are considered the oldest unbroken oral tradition in existence. UNESCO proclaimed the tradition of the Vedic chant a masterpiece of the oral and intangible heritage of humanity on November 7, 2008. Unfortunately, in today's time, these systems are deemed irrelevant and sometimes even opposed by the anti-Hindu propaganda. One should be a secular and a liberal, but today's definition of secularism and liberalism has changed to anti-Hinduism. Today, people neither from the left nor from the right-wing ideology have a deeper understanding of the Vedic culture. Instead of following the right-wing or the left-wing propaganda, one should follow the facts if one wants to find out the truth. Because the truth is the only thing that matters. So follow our page Satyalok on Instagram, where we will explore the ancient Indian culture without having a political or a religious dogma and only through a factual perspective. So stay tuned, stay educated, and last but not the least, know your culture by self-investigating the truth. Shubhaste Panthanaha Santu, Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.